Hey guys, so in this video what I'm going to do is I'm going to take Windows PowerShell, and by default it is supposed to look something like this, and I'm going to make it look something like this. Alright, so to get this new prompt, the first thing you're going to need is to clone one of my repositories. So I already created the script that sets up everything for you on its own, so you don't have to do anything manually. And I'm gonna put this link in the description. It's github.com evanusrath my Windows terminal. So this is the repository, and it contains these install scripts. Let's just clone this somewhere. And it's going to be git clone https github.com evanusrath my Windows terminal. Okay, so it is cloned now. And let's cd into this directory. So as you can see, there are basically two of these scripts, install step one and install step two. So first of all, you're going to have to run the first script, but it is possible that PowerShell won't allow you to run this script, because by default running the scripts is actually limited only to the signed scripts. So if you face any error at this point, basically just to run the script, you're just gonna have to write something like install step one.ps1, right? But it is possible that it shows some error after you run this. So all you're gonna have to do is open Windows PowerShell as an administrator, and then you're gonna have to paste this command. So set execution policy remote signed, and then it is going to allow you to run that script if you face that error, right? But I think for me that shouldn't be required, because I think I've already changed that. Let's hope it works. So I'm going to run this script. So this is the first PS1, right? Step 1.ps1. So I'm going to run this, and it's going to do a whole bunch of things for me, and we're just going to have to wait and see the progress, and hopefully there won't be any errors in the process. Alright, so it seems like this has completed successfully. As you can see, it says please exit Windows PowerShell and launch Windows Terminal from Start menu. Then run install step 2 to continue the setup. Press any key to continue. Alright, so far so good. Let's close Windows PowerShell and launch Windows Terminal. Yeah, it's showing up here. So I'm going to launch this. So I'm inside Windows PowerShell. Let me just cd into my Windows Terminal directory again. It's the same folder that I cloned earlier. And now I'm just going to run the second step, which is install step 2.ps1. Okay. And hopefully this would also work flawlessly. Okay, so you guys might see this error, but don't worry too much about it. You can just click OK. Hopefully all settings have been applied correctly. Just exit terminal one last time and launch it again. All right. So this is looking a little bit ugly, but don't worry about it. Let's close terminal and launch terminal again. And there you have it. Okay. This you can change on your own, but let's cd into my Windows Terminal, clear, Okay, so you guys can see, since we're on Windows, so we see the Windows icon, we see the directory, we see then we're on the master branch. We can also see that this particular folder is being hosted on GitHub. I personally changed the name of this, the color of this git config to black. So that can also be done. But yeah, this is it. One thing you can do is go to the settings and click PowerShell. Yeah, PowerShell is running. Let's go to appearance and let's set acrylic and click save. Okay. So now you'll see that there is this blur which makes you it's just gonna make the text much more readable. And yeah, this is it. This is all you need to do to get a really nice prompt on Windows.